Hare Krishna. Another very, very important pastime that took place here. Some sages came here to worship Lord Shiva. Among them was Nibadaitya, very powerful sage. He came here and began to worship Lord Shiva with other sages. Lord Shiva appeared and blessed them to become pure devotees of Krishna. And he specifically told Nibadaitya, Kripa kori panchabakra kohila takhan ei grama prante ache dibbo billavan. He told Nibadaitya that end of this village there is a beautiful bilva forest, and in that forest the four Kumaras are there meditating on the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Approach them. By their mercy, you will get transcendental knowledge. You will understand the goal of life. Accept them as your spiritual master. So hearing this instruction directly from Lord Shiva's lotus mouth, Nibadaitya came to this very place, and from distance he saw the four Kumaras totally absorbed in meditation. And Nibadaitya began to chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hearing this beautiful kirtan by Nibadaitya, the four Kumaras opened their eyes and asked, Ke tumi keno bahetha bolo porichoy, tomar prarthana mora purabo nischoy. Who are you? Where are you from? What do you desire? We are very, very pleased with you and will fulfill your desire. Nibadaitya introduced himself. Hearing about Nibadaitya, understanding his simplicity, his devotion to Lord Shiva and to the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna, the four Kumaras were very, very pleased. And they began to explain, just like Ramanujacharya is accepted by Lakshmi Devi as the prominent Acharya in Sri Sampradaya, Madhvacharya is accepted by Lord Brahma, Vishnu Swami is accepted by Lord Shiva. So you, Nibadaitya, will be accepted as the most prominent Acharya in our line, headed by the four Kumaras. And the four Kumaras initiated Nibadaitya. The four Kumaras instructed Nibadaitya about the process of devotional service. Nibadaitya began to worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead Sri Krishna here. And there is a beautiful description in Navadwip Mahatmya by Bhaktivinoda Thakur that Sri Sri Radha and Madhava, being very pleased with Nibadaitya, they appeared in front of Nibadaitya. Ruper chhatai chatur dik alo hoila. The whole place was lit up by the effulgence of Radha and Krishna. Smiling, with a smiling face, they began to speak to Nibadaitya, telling him how pleased they are by his sadhana. began to explain how at the age of Kali, very soon he will appear as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And suddenly, right in front of Nibadaitya, Radha and Krishna both transformed themselves together as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Nibadaitya fell unconscious. By the mercy of the Lord, he regained his consciousness and Mahaprabhu blessed him that when I appear, you will also appear as Keshav Kashmiri. And all of you know about the beautiful pastime of Mahaprabhu defeating Keshav Kashmiri, who has defeated everyone whom he has met in all directions. But when he came to Navadvip, he was defeated by Sriman Mahaprabhu. So Nibadaitya actually appeared as Keshav Kashmiri in Mahaprabhu's pastime. So this is a very, very important place for the devotees. So when we come here, we hear how Lord Shiva is so pleased when someone approaches him to be guided to worship Krishna. He is most pleased. And we also heard that anyone who endeavors to worship Srimad Mahaprabhu, to worship Krishna in this place, Lord Shiva will personally come and introduce you to Srimad Mahaprabhu. Hare Krishna.
Do you like our ad-free videos? Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.